A rare one developed faith by listening to my story. The listening or the talk is between God and devotee, or Guru and the disciple. In spirituality, the main are God and the Guru. Guru is nothing but the embodiment of knowledge. One who is full of knowledge is the Guru. In the inner core, there is the sense of being, which is unasked for, undesired. Attention means sense of being, our knowledge we are. God tells the devotee that the knowledge you are is in the body, but it is my form, the form of knowledge. Although the knowledge resides in the body, it is untouched by it. God confirms that Guru, who is an embodiment of knowledge, is God's form. The listener is knowledge. It is my greatest devotee. It is my form. Who is Hari, where he is, and who is the devotee of Hari? The devotee of God is bound to him by love. But what is bound in love? It is your consciousness, the knowledge that you are. Wherever there is the sense of being, there is also self-love. He wrongly identifies with the body instead of with God. One who listens to Hari's story and develops the faith that what is listening is the form of God. If the knowledge you are is not there in the body, who will listen to the Hari's story? In the absence of the knowledge you are, there is no worldly experience. Ishvara tells you that the knowledge you are is my form. One who is convinced that his knowledge is the form of Ishvara, for him everything becomes easy and smooth. But what we observe is that people do good deeds. They visit places of pilgrimages and with all this, without leaving the body identity.
So, dhyati olaf vegari karun, dhyati maagit mi asrati dhyan, manja apne rupaye, ati tu abhed bhakti karun.
A rare one separates his identity from the body and worships God with oneness.
Svaita bhakti karun, chalat maagit kripa, al maagit dhyan hoti.
God says that one who worships me with non-duality knows me and he gets my grace. Such a blessed one knows that the knowledge he is the form of God, form of Brahman. When the knowledge you are identifies itself with the God, it develops all the qualities of God.
अशा इच्छा वासना ज्ञाना लायक असतात अज्ञाना लायक
नसतात. The hopes, desires and cravings befit or they apply to the body and not to the self.
ज्ञान स्मरण करून जो वाचतो आहे त्याला अशा इच्छा वासना कल्पना त्याला भोगावे लागतात.
One who behaves remembering himself to be the body suffers because of the hope, desires and the cravings.
परंतु जो मागे चढ्डा घेतो आहे मी चैतन्य रूप भगवान काय म्हणजे आहे आणि तो असल्यामुळे आपण आणि जो घेता अनुभव घेतो आहे.
God says, one who has faith in me knows that he is consciousness, he is God residing in the body and because of the consciousness he has the knowledge that he is and that the world is.
Chala akal man vastavik dyate na hai tyate nav nave dyate rupe tyate rup nave.
In fact he has no form, the name and form of the body is not his.
Ase jo jantu hai to mala atma la odakto ani majya atma cha kratela layak hoto.
God says that such a person knows me and deserves my grace. When you listen something, you reject some and accept some. But the most worthy thing to accept is the knowledge you are. We have to consider the knowledge we are as the Guru, Bhagwan, and ultimately we ourselves.
अच्छा त्रिपुटी ज्यांनी एक करून पळालेला आहे त्याला ज्ञान प्राप्ती होते आणि खरे खोटे
करायला. One who has accepted these three, that is Guru, God and his own beingness, he comes to know his true being.
ज्या बुद्धीने जे आवडत होते ते त्यांचे असे वाटते.
He comes to know that whatever was lovable because of the body identity is worth rejecting. But such an understanding is very rare.
मरे मरे करते तरी पण आपण मरणार या खातीरने वाचतोय.
बट नॉर्मली पीपल डू स्पिरिच्युअलिटी थ्रू आउट देअर लाईफ, बट दे हॅव द कन्व्हिक्शन अँड दे लिव्ह विथ द कन्व्हिक्शन दे आर गोइंग टू डार.
जो पर्यंत आपले मात दिवस रात्रीवर मोजता आणि त्याच्यावर तुमचे आयुष्य ठरवता.
बट एज लॉंग एज यू काउंट द टाइम with the help of day and night and decide your life accordingly,
jo paryant tumhala jyacha ulkita akar jyacha upatita akar tumhi manta to paryant tumhala dhyan jhala nahi.
So long as you believe that you were born, you are not knowledgeable, you do not have self knowledge.
Jala atman dhyan jhalela ahe त्याला काळाचे भय नाही.
वन हु हॅज सेल्फ नॉलेज हॅज नो फिअर ऑफ टाइम.
ज्ञान असताना सुद्धा त्याला आयुष्याची गरज नाही. ज्ञान असताना आयुष्याची गरज नाही. विना आयुष्यात चिरंतन राहतो.
जस्ट एज वेन देर इज नो बॉडी देर इज नो नीड फॉर लाईफ, सिमिलरली ही रिमेन्स इमॉर्टल.
विना आयुष्य परिपूर्ण राहतो.
Without life span he remains in his totality.
Ase asun sudha dyacha lobhane aplya prabal ichhene maran orun yeto.
One who has desire for the body ultimately dies.
Marana hi marana vikalpana chala aahe chala atmanyan dhalele nahi.
One who believes in the concept of death has no self knowledge.
Ani atmanyan jala dhalela aahe tyala mi marana hi kalpana rahat.
The idea of death doesn't touch one who has self knowledge.
Matra jala dist sakalcha nisarga karto to nisarga kartana bhare vat.
Every morning at the time of excretion and urination you feel fine.
Te kartana bhare vat santa kare प्राण काय असं म्हणतोय काय बरोबर मन जातोय प्राणे काय काय असं बरोबर काय चैतन्य ज्ञान त्या ठिकाणी गुणाचे निर्गुण होते.
ऍट द एंड ऑफ द बॉडी वेन वायटल ब्रेथ लीव्स माइंड ऑल्सो गोज द कॉन्शियसनेस ऑर द नोईंगनेस बिकम्स नो नोईंग.
स्वच्छ झाला दिसते ज्ञान हा गुण निर्गुण झाला आणखी प्राण आणि मन निघून गेले.
इट इज क्लिअर टू द सेल्फ दॅट द वायटल ब्रेथ अँड माइंड लेफ्ट अँड द नोईंगनेस बिकेम नो नोईंग.
बाकी राहिला कोण तिथे मरणारा कोण तिथे.
हु इज लेफ्ट बिहाइंड हु इज देअर टू डाय.
प्राणही नेला नाही गुणही नेला नाही.
द वायटल ब्रेथ डीड नॉट डाय द कॉन्शियसनेस ऑल्सो did not die.
Gunai sagun brahmaji murti aahe.
Consciousness is the form of the manifest brahman.
Pratitite pran gela barobar nirgun jala.
But when the vital breath left the consciousness became no conscious.
Kuthe gele ali nahi.
It did not go anywhere.
Atma jana jana bhanlela aahe kuthe gele jat nahi.
Thus the self is eternally full, it doesn't come or go.
Guru vachana pramane jani aple kare samajh kara jana manjala ni manush hai agra manto ni chaitanya dev hai chaitanya bhagwan hai prakash roop hai kaya roop nahi ase jacha kaam lagdo.
But one who is consistent with guru's words knows that he is not the body, his form is light, God, consciousness. Such a person receives the knowledge of the self and finds his hopes, desires and cravings fulfilled, so that there is no need to hope, desire and crave. As long as you have hopes and desires, know that you are not realized, you don't have the knowledge of the Self. Because fullness is the nature of the Self. One who feels that he was born and takes the form and qualities of the body as he is, ultimately dies. In reality, no one has the experience of death. Although one is consciousness, one is God, he believes in what the people say about death. Such a person experiences pain, but one who has heard the God's story and one who has faith in it, he is always in the state of pleasure, joy. Several worlds were formed and dissolved, but the Self has remained intact. The Self is untouched and full of joy. The Self has remained untouched by displeasure and fear. This riddle of life gets solved if one follows Guru's words and lives them, that his form is God. You may do anything, but your conviction that you are going to die one day will remain. Due to your body identity, there will be no end to your journey of births and deaths. In the case of a real seeker, the reality shines as I am not this, I am this, I am not this, I am this. This doesn't happen in all cases because of the faith in the body, because of their body identity. One who has faith in the body has no faith in the Self. The Self is beyond birth and death, beyond time, and it is all pervasive. The Self is not an individual. It is manifest. It is infinite and without limits. This can happen to you if you adhere to your form that you are knowledge, you are God. But if you remain with your body identity, you will have to die and take birth not only once but many times. When you adhere to your form of consciousness, your worthiness improves day by day and you realize your true identity. His joy increases day by day. He gets established in the consciousness and forgets the body identity. We wear slippers and shoes of various types, but we are not that. Everyone knows that one is not the shoes. Similarly, one also knows that one is not the body covered by the skin or leather. I make use of the body, I take care of it, but that is not my form. Just as I am not the shoes, I am also not the body. Our consciousness, our sense of being is subtler than space. It is clearer than space. It is cleaner than space and more pious. Let some of you, or at least anyone, make the discrimination of the permanent and the impermanent and be one with the self. Your friendship and oneness with your body will remain as long as you don't make friendship and oneness with the self. When the friendship and oneness with the self is made, as that is the eternal God, nothing can affect him. What is implicit faith? It is self-love, the need to be. It is the form of the all-powerful God.
Yes,
The sages who have experienced it have proclaimed that a person who has such a faith is Bhagwan, he is God himself. Our sense of being, our knowledge, we are, is the form of God. There is nothing great other than this. With our sense of being, there is existence of everything. When it is not, there is nothing. With such understanding, one remains joyful, full of joy. The pleasure derived from doing something or from external thing is not real pleasure. You experience pleasure by doing so many activities, but that is not real pleasure. The experience of the inner freedom is the real joy. That real joy doesn't depend on any activities. One involves oneself in various activities and makes life tolerable and thinks that it is pleasure. Without the various activities, our existence will become intolerable. Our true identity is the self whose nature is full of joy. One who is faithful enjoys this joy. He need not do anything else. This joy is of the self. This joy is not bodily pleasure. The body needs attention or activities for pleasure, but that which is the form of which is joy itself doesn't need any activities or attention. You must develop implicit faith and remain in the awareness or in the sight of the self. You must do yoga of knowledge, yoga of self. With the help of these yogas, in this very life, in this very body, you will attain the state of the eternal Parabrahman. But you have no time to make friendship with the self. All the time you are involved in various acquaintances and with your relations.
Atman jara se sev sarvi kendra hai. तो शुद्ध ब्रह्मा परम ब्रह्मा आहे हे स्पष्ट बघून घेता येईल त्याला पाहून घेता येईल तुला स्वरूपाने राहता येईल.
इफ यू मेक फ्रेंडशिप विथ युअर सेल्फ यू विल बी एबल टू रिमेन विथ युअर ट्रू आयडेंटिटी विथ युअर ट्रू सेल्फ द स्टेट ऑफ प्युअर परब्रह्म.
तर या जगाचा आत्मचंद्र वाढवा आणि आत्मशांतीने राहा.
फॉर दॅट यू मस्ट डेव्हलप इम्प्लिसिट फेथ इन द सेल्फ अँड कंटिन्यू इन दॅट स्टेट.